As you can see, I'm not Alicia. Alicia is here. It is my student. We are working in an applied math lab laboratory, but we are doing theoretical astrophysics for a long time for me. This is, I think you see, you know, this is a very difficult problem because there is observations are very difficult to obtain, theory very difficult, and numerics is very powerful, but you can do what you want. So you have to mix with all these points. And for the time, I wish to present like a summary of the situation, if you want. And at the end, I give to you some ideas about to have a good idea of what happens in such systems. So at the beginning, I will speak about facts about astrophysics. Our problem is concerned by the globular clusters and galaxies. Not large-scale structures, which is like Michael Jost said, it is another problem. It is more you have to include general relativity. In this case, you are on small scales of the universe, galactic scales, and the general relativity is not important. The second problem I wish to evoke is the problem of the equilibrium state, in which equilibrium we observe such systems. It is not a very simple problem, as you see. After you, I present some instabilities because I think there is a few instabilities occurs in these systems, and they are very interesting to make a good scenario, which I present at the end. So. Some facts. The standard model of stellar dynamics is very well known. This is a system with n components in gravitational interaction. As n is very large, you are in a mean field limit. So it is a problem in which a test particle is associated to a distribution function which evolves in a gravitational potential. And the dynamic equations are the Vlasov-Poisson system. With a mass density, which is the integral of the distribution function over velocities. And there is two time constants in this problem, a short time, which is a dynamical time, which is can obtain this time in a different way. But you get always this order of magnitude, 1 over the square root of g, the Newton constant, times the mean density of the system. This is the time taken by a star to go to one side to the other side of the galaxy, if you want. And there is another time, which is a long time, sometimes considered as infinite in such systems. This is the time taken by collision to change by an order of magnitude the velocity in the system. So it is a very old calculus by Chandrasekhar in the middle of the last century. And you get there is a lot of controversy about this result, but everybody is almost in accordance with this formula, only in details, we are not agree. And you see that this time is n times this time. So if n is equal to some billions, like in galaxy, as this time is some hundred millions years. You understand that this time is very, very long in comparison between the age of the universe. So sometimes you can consider that this time is infinite. But for globular clusters, which are less, there is less stars, almost 1,000 or 10,000, 100,000 stars, You can have the effect of the collision in globular clusters. Let me see this point. So here you have two representative globular clusters. We are lovely object in the sky. If you never seen a globular cluster in a telescope, let's try. It's very impressive to see in the reality. You can do this with a small telescope. It is very possible. It is so you are here the two kind of globular cluster. This one with a large core and this one with a collapsed core. The difference is very very remarkable. So when you plot the density of stars in function of the radius of the system, in this kind of system you have a large core and after a halo, and in this kind of system you have no more large core and as we said a cusp in the core. Okay, so they said astrophysicists said that this kind of globular cluster are core collapsed. And you have almost 80% of the globular system, the system of the galaxy. In our galaxy, there are almost 100 globular clusters. And there is almost 80 in this state and 20 in this state. Okay? And we can say that this effect is an evolution effect. How we can say this? This is a very, very easy. It's simple to say. You plot all the globular cluster in a diagram, which is here. You are the it is a globular cluster, the half mass radius RH, R tidal, the limit of, and here an estimation of the radius of the core. And when you plot all the globular cluster of the galaxy in this diagram, you see that there are this repartition. When you identify where there are collapsed core by this symbol, okay, they are all here. And why I said it is an evolution effect is because when you make a color which represents the time, the dynamical time of the system, you see that all the collapsed core are the blue one. And the blue one are the one that have the smaller dynamical time. So during the evolution of the galaxy, their evolution of the galaxy, during 10 billion years, they are affected by collision, and the effect of collision makes this core to collapse, as we see in a moment. The model for globular cluster is very old. There is no more explanation, but it is very old. There is an explanation, but the explanation is not so good as. This is the King model. The King model, it is a fine-tuned heuristic model. You consider an isothermal sphere, we will see why, and you cut it because you have some problem at the end of the distribution. So King said, there is no problem. We have to cut and there is no more problem. And you obtain this model. And with three parameters, you can fit very well. This is two globular clusters with a core, and you can see that you can fit with very good accuracy the data and the model. Okay, and the collapsed core are rather like an isothermal singular sphere, so the density profile is only a halo radius to the power minus 2. For the galaxy, the situation is rather different. In fact, you have two kinds of galaxies. You have LSB, which are large, low surface brightness galaxies. We are small galaxies, isolated galaxies, and which are a core halo fashioned. You can see here such of LSB, which LSB represent, in fact, 90% of all the galaxies. we can see. Either we have a, it is not very seeable. But when you plot the density, if you can, of such an object, it is very recent, 10 or 20 years we are able to do this. We obtain a core halo structure, a core with no slope here and a two, minus 2 in the power in the slope. So this is for LSB galaxies. And for high surface brightness galaxy, we have such a profile. For such a galaxy or for galaxy formed in the large scale structure simulation by cosmologists, for example, you obtain such, for example, they said this is a NFW profile or NSTO profile. And in fact, there is a study by Merit some years ago, 10 years ago, which said that NFW is not the same, the better, but the best, but rather equivalent profile, which is, it is Prunier-Simien, which is here. And this is a deprojection of the famous Devaux-Couleur law. And this deprojection, in this deprojection, you see an exponential, and you can think that there is some thermodynamics in back, in front. Okay. The difference between these two kinds of galaxies is not an evolution of the system like in globular cluster. It's what I think. I am not only the one to think this. The difference between these two systems is between the history and the evolution, the formation of the galaxy. So now, what is the problem with equilibrium? If you want to describe a galaxy by thermodynamics, it is a null problem with a null solution, a solution by Lindenbell in 1767. This is a violent relaxation. So you split the phase space into energy macrocells. You divide these macrocells into microcells of the same, all in macrocells contain all the particles with the same energy. And after, you compute to maximize the number of compaction under constraints. But there is a lot of problems. Are the particles distinguishable or not? What are the actual constraints? The energy, the mass, the angular momentum, or whatever. Can we use, this is not a simple remark, can we use a Stirling formula at first order, like everything do in thermodynamics, statistical thermodynamics? Is it the result, is it a Vlasov equilibrium? And other question I don't, not hit. So, let me present for the person who don't know this, the Lindenbell result. So in this calculation, Lindenbell supposed that particles are distinguishable, but in fact, if you see in details, he supposed that all the particles have the same mass. So it is a little bit contradictory use. The constraints imposed are the total mass, the conservation of the total mass, and the conservation of the total energy. And as you know, gravitation imposes a classical Pauli principle because you can put two particles at the same place due to gravitation. So when you compute the number of complexion, you obtain this way, which is the Fermi-Dirac. With distribution with distinguishable particles, and when you compute the distribution, when you look for in this set, so a set of distribution with a finite mass and a finite energy, when you compute the maximum of the entropy. Of entropy-like, you obtain a Fermi-Dirac distribution. As gravitational systems are not degenerate, you can consider that NE is very smaller than GE, the degenerescence of the state. then this distribution reduces to the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. So this is the conclusion of Lind and Bell, but it is good because in the thermodynamic limit, when n goes to infinity, you obtain a Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. When you integrate this distribution over the velocity, you obtain a density, which is an exponential of minus an inverse temperature times the potential. And when you plug into the Vlasov equation, you obtain such an equation. And when you use Gidas and Nirenberg theorem pure mathematical theorem, it is said to you that such a system is spherical. So you are happy because everybody thinks that all the gravitating systems are spherical. For example, all the globular clusters are spherical. There are a few not spherical globular clusters, but there is a slow rotation who can explain it. You say to me that the spiral galaxies are not spherical, but if you have only a disk galaxy, the disk is unstable. So around the disk, you have a spherical dark matter halo. So in this context, all is spherical. So it is a good result, but you have a lot of problems with this result. I speak with two problems. First of all, this is a classical problem of this kind of calculus. The result is not in the set where you are looking for, because when you compute the behavior, the density you obtain in the outer region, and you obtain that at the limit when r goes to infinity, the density goes like r to the power minus 2. There is a minus here. So when you integrate to obtain the mass over R3, you obtain a divergence. So this system has not a finite mass, and you are looking for a system with a finite mass in the basic hypothesis. So it is a problem. A less classic problem, it is perhaps for me, you are looking for a maximum of the entropy in a system which is described as a Vlasov equation. And Vlasov equation conserves the entropy. What does it mean to search the maximum of the entropy when it is conserved? It is, for me, it is a problem. But perhaps it is not a problem. The classical solution, like King model, we have a cut of this problem. So if you cut, you have no problem. But you cut after, at the end of the story, you have to cut at the beginning, to be honest. So the cut, the King cut or boxed, there is a large theory in which people put isothermal sphere in a box, so you haven't such problems. But what is this box? Okay. But if you cut, you have not no more the problem of infinite mass, but you still have the problem of Vlasov. And there is two modern ideas to solve these two problems simultaneously. The first is a paper by a Brazilian guy and I when this famous trimester when Jihad was in Paris 2 years ago. We have... I will present to you. Our idea 6 years ago by Orge and Lily Williams, they said that at the end of this system, larger, the concentration, the number of stars are not so sufficient to use the Stirling formula cut at the first order. And when you consider over terms, second order terms, and more complicated terms, this gives a finite mass to the system. It is so simple. Why they don't think to this before? And I show you what it gives when you do this change. So the distinguishability problem, this is an idea with Beraldo et al. 2 years ago. The violent relaxation of self-gravitation, self-gravitating system is not able to produce a full mixed state. It is well known. And collisions are needed to fully mix the system. But collision takes a long time. So when the system is collapsed, the system is not in a full mixed state. After a few dynamical states, the system only is partially mixed, and the phase space contains isolated mixed island. So particles in mixed region are indistinguishable among themselves, but distinguishable between the other islands. So in fact, you can consider that all particles are the same property in regards to the distinguishability. There are a set of particles we are distinguishable and a set of particles we are indistinguishable. So when you do this, the number of complex using these remarks become this in this way, and when you do the same calculus, you obtain this distribution. And when it is Maxwellian, you will see it. But this kind of assumption breaks the Vlasov symmetry, because to obtain Vlasov equation, you know that you have to stop the BBGKY hierarchy, and you have to suppose that all the particles are the same law in this in probability. And in this case, they don't have the same law. So this gives the possibility to the entropy to grow during the violent relaxation. You obtain this kind of distribution function, this kind of density profile. So it is always interesting. You have a core and a halo, but you are still faced to the problem of the mass. Here, this is the slope of the halo. Okay, so you see that, including this remark of distinguishability, the slope is always -2 at the end of the system. So when you consider the new Stirling approximation, as I said in this paper, the situation is changed, and this is the same. You are always a Maxwellian, so it is so good for explain what you see. And in this case, you see that the slope is not longer 2, and it is 4. It depends of parameters. Okay, so this kind of system has a finite mass, so you don't have any problem, and you don't have to cut it before doing the job. Okay. Let me now speak about instabilities quickly. The first instability which fashion self-gravitating system is the Jeans instability. This is very well known. It is a Landau relaxation. It is a lot of name. It is very simple. When you consider an homogeneous system, with a velocity dispersion, with a constant density, and with a radius, when the radius of this system is greater than a certain radius, which is the Jeans radius, the Jeans length, then the system collapses. And what you obtain after the collapse, in fact, you obtain a core halo structure. It's always the same thing. And not a general core halo structure. In general, you obtain a core with a halo with a slope with -4. And what we do with Alicia, we remark that this model you obtain is an isochron model. Let me say a few words about this isochron model, because it is a very, very interesting and fabulous model by Michel Hénon, Hénon Health. Hénon, it is in 1958. And the idea of this model, you know that when you have a sphere, I don't resist to write on this marvelous blackboard. You consider a star in this system, And you know that this star is characterized by an energy and a square momentum. You know that the orbit of this star in this system is lie in a plane. It is a first year problem, first year university problem. And you know that you can the rosette, okay, the orbit in this plane. And so you can you have the distance to the center of this star is periodic. And you can compute the period, and it is very easy between the pericenter to the apocenter. This is very simple. If you don't know, you can find it in classical books. The energy minus the potential minus the square of the momentum. So you can see that in general, this period of the star depends on the energy and on the square momentum. And Michel Hénon asks the question: what are the more general potentials for which this period do not depend on L2? Okay, and the name of this potential are the isochron potential, and he obtains the formula. Formula is very simple. It is minus like this. So you can see that when B equal to zero, an isochron it is a Kepler potential. When B goes to infinity, you can show that this potential is equal to the harmonic potential, and in between it is the isochron potential. And what you obtain after the genes instability, you can see here, it is this potential. And I think I understand why. It is not in 2 years ago in the middle of this amphitheater. So here you are the collapse, and in blue, and in black you are the density. When you put it into the Vlasov equation, you obtain this formula with only one parameter. And when you fit the data with the model, it is okay. So the isochron model is the product of the violent relaxation in this sense. The second instability, it is well known by the people like you. It is Antonov instability, because it is a thermodynamical problem. When you put an isothermal sphere in a box with four parameters, an energy, a temperature, a mass, and a radius, we can show that when R goes to infinity, the mass goes to infinity too, because it is an isothermal sphere. But when you cut the system, you put it in a box, there is no problem with mass. But you cannot put any isothermal sphere in any box. You have constraints. If you fix the temperature, then the good parameter is the density contrast. It is the ratio between the value of the density at the center of the system and on the edge of the system. And when you want to put an isothermal sphere fixing the temperature with a density contrast larger than this number, it is impossible. And when you fix the energy, the density contrast for the instability is less. This is well known. This is ensemble at the basis of the ensemble inequivalence. And I make the remark that this instability, Antonov instability, the value of the parameter of instability is much more less, is very when you add a thermostat to the system. This is the problem of caloric curve. I think you know this kind of problems. And the result of an isothermal sphere in a box, it is a Corallo system. And the result, the product of the gravothermal instability, of the Antonov instability, is the collapse of the core. So we think that it is what happens for globular clusters. Such a systems have a density contrast we grow during their evolution, and when their density contrast go up to the limit, the core shrink and collapse, and you obtain, this is the common explication. Less known instability, this is a radial orbit instability. When you have we have done a proof some years ago of it is a very strange instability. It is an instability which needs dissipation to develop. It is very interesting. I refer to the paper to see it. And this instability transforms a sphere into a triaxial system. The mechanism is the following. When you are a system which is rich in the velocity space, radial velocity space, and when you add a non-radial perturbation with a direction which is non like the others, you pull this is radial, this is pencil, this is radial orbits, and this extend one of the orbits, and there is a torque existing between this orbit and the other. We are close to this, and after there is a strange, and this is at the end you obtain a stable equilibrium which is no more spherical. I can show this mechanism is very, very complicated. What you have to keep in mind is you can produce this instability not only in simulation but in reality. How to do this instability in reality? But you have to make a collapse of something onto something. Let me show something about this. So here you have a Plumer sphere, which is a elliptical, a spherical galaxy, and around it you have an homogeneous system. And this homogeneous system is gene unstable, and the gene's instability is parameted by the initial virial ratio. When you are far from one, minus one, the instability is very strong, and when you are near one, the instability is not so strong. So when you make a collapse of a system onto another system, you can obtain this instability. It's evident on the simulation, and you can prove it. In this case, the system receives a lot of radial velocity in this phase space, so it develops the radial orbit instability and develops a bar. In this case, it receives not sufficient amount of radial velocity, and the instability cannot develop. We think that this kind of instability is at the origin of a primordial elliptical galaxy. In a few years ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, when they do simulations, cosmologists, can't explain why there is earlier a primordial elliptical galaxy. They think that all the elliptical galaxies are the product of the merging of two spirals. And so there is no reason to have elliptical galaxy at the beginning of the universe in the simulation. In using this kind of instability, you can produce such a galaxy when you want. But in fact, when you have produced such a galaxy, and if it is not isolated, there is a merging process, something go onto it, etc., etc., and it loses its possibility to remain elliptical. But in fact, there is a footprint of this instability in the slope of the density. It is a very interesting paper by Katz. You see it. And this instability is very important to observe what we observe. Okay. So let me finish. Okay. No. Okay. I finish by putting all these things together. What is the paradigm to explain the formation and evolution of globular cluster system? At the beginning, you have an initial homogeneous cloud. It suffers violent relaxation genes instability. It forms an isochron. The collision on a very few time, dynamical time, on a longer time, there is a collision who produced a system like a king, and after the evolution can make the core of the king collapse to form the 20% of the globular cluster you obtain. In the galaxy context, it is different. If you have a hierarchic scenario, so you can idealize by two systems, a smaller into a bigger one. For dynamical reasons, this is the smaller which collapses first. So the first collapse on the gene time scales to form an isochron. But in this context, the bigger one is a thermostat. And in this case, the critical radius, the critical density contrast is very smaller than 700, and it is equal to 2 and 4. So the Antonov instability occurs at the very beginning of the formation of the system, and you have all this part of the system is pushed towards the center. And it is a good hypothesis, a good mechanism to explain why there is object which is in the scope of GIAD, because it is a good possibility to form supermassive black holes, which are not present in the other paradigm. We have never seen a big black hole at the center of a globular cluster. After the big system collapse onto this, and you can produce such thing with a black hole at the center, or already with always with the black hole. But if the collapse is violent, as we see in the simulation, you can obtain a triaxial structure like an elliptical galaxy. Thank you.